Hey guys, welcome back. My name is Veena Azmanov from VeenaAzmanov.com, where I show you how to cook, bake, and decorate with confidence. Today I'm showing you how I make roast chicken in a Dutch oven. There is so much to love about this recipe because the chicken is wonderfully roasted on top, but at the bottom there is these wonderful caramelized vegetables, and everything just happens in one pan. The best thing is you have leftovers for the week when you can make sandwiches and everything. So let's get started with a very simple and very easy recipe. We're going to start by preheating our oven to 425 degrees Fahrenheit, 210 degrees Celsius. In the bottom of my Dutch oven, I've got some shallots, which I have peeled and halved. You can keep them whole if they are small. And then, of course, I've got some celery and carrots. I'm going to put them all at the bottom of the pan. And I've also got one large garlic, which I have just cut in half. It's a whole bulb, and I'm going to put some olive oil. You want to make sure that your vegetables are nicely coated in the olive oil, and season it with salt and pepper. This is all going to sit at the bottom of your chicken and going to get all the chicken marinade juices falling right over it. Last but not the least, we are going to add some fresh herbs. Today I've got some rosemary and thyme. I'm going to put the Dutch oven aside and I'm going to work on the chicken. The first thing you want to do is make sure that your chicken is thawed and it's not frozen or cold. You want to always work with a nice room temperature chicken, and you want to make sure that the chicken is nicely dried. If the chicken has too much of moisture from the defrosting, it is going to stew, not roast. The next thing you want to do is generously season it with salt and pepper. Now, quite often we don't add enough salt and pepper because the bird is really big and the salt and pepper just stays on top. So you want to make sure that you season it generously with salt and pepper inside and out. Don't forget to do that inside the cavity right there. Okay. Next, we're going to take some lemon, onion, and garlic and add it inside the cavity. This is going to season the flavor the chicken from inside. The next thing we want to do is tie or truss our chicken with elbow twine. It's a very simple and very easy. Just tie the legs together. Now, if you are new to my channel, welcome to my channel. I hope you will like and subscribe. Hit the notification bell for more videos from me. I post at least one video a week, so don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. The next thing we're going to do is brush the chicken with melted butter. This is going to flavor but also give us a nice wonderful golden color for our chicken. So make sure you give it a nice generous smear of butter all over. And that's it. This is going to go into our Dutch oven and into the oven, which is preheating at the moment. Now this is going to cook on high for about 70 to 90 minutes, or until the internal temperature of the chicken and the thickest part of the thigh reaches about 165 degrees Fahrenheit. If you don't have a thermometer, then I will leave a guide for you in the bottom of the video just as a guide. But a thermometer is the best way to know that your chicken is cooked or not. Now this is all ready and done. You want to make sure that you let the chicken cool for about 15 to 20 minutes before you carve into it, so that the juices have a time to rest. Make sure that when you're taking the chicken out of the Dutch oven, it's very hot, so be careful. So I hope you will try this recipe. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, and of course subscribe and hit the notification bell for more videos from me. If you do try my recipe, don't forget to tag me on any social media, Veena Azmanov. I love watching pictures or getting tagged when people try my recipes. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope you will join me on my next video. Bye-bye and have a lovely week.